Morning.
Good morning, man. Welcome back. You got a couple of people waiting on you.
Yes, sir.
Working out for baseball.
Okay? Appreciate that. Yes, sir. Thank you. What's up, baby?
What's up, baby?
Good to see you.
How are you?
Good, good. What's up, baby?
What's up?
Oh,
how you feeling?
Good. Feeling good. I got the idea from Tulo. You know, he held something similar to this, and he invited me out to Vegas, and you know, pretty much took me through his whole off-season routine. Like, I spent a week with him, and to see like what it was like, man, to really work like that. And that's kind of the thought behind it, and I know it resonated well with me, so why not give, you know, some of these young guys that opportunity as well. You know, you get to kind of build a relationship with some of these young guys that, you know, most likely are gonna be a big part of the future of the Red Sox. We're all excited, it's the new year, and we're feel like everyone's clicking, we're ready to go, ready to play baseball now. Seeing the way Tulo did it and the attention to detail and just every little thing, man, there was no box left unchecked. At one of the, like the very end of the workout, talking to Tulo, you know, we were kind of wrapping up. I was about to head home, and he was like, "You think anyone else worked harder than us, like in the MLB today or this week?" And I was like, "I don't think so." He's like, "Yeah, that's what it takes to be the best shortstop in the league."
Nice.
Do you cut the sleeves off those shirts, or they come like that?
They come like that.
For real?
Yeah.
It's kind of like him, bro. It's like Belichick vibes.
I mean, everything Trevor says kind of just makes sense. I mean, he's been around baseball for a long time, and he's been in the bigs for a long time, so the dude knows what he's talking about, and, you know, whenever he talks, you know, you probably should listen.
I learned a lot from Tulo is, like, the angles of it.
Yeah.
Like, pretty much if the ball's to my right, like, I'm pretty much gonna backhand no matter what, you know? Like, for me, fighting to like really get around it and like, boom, it was just harder for me to get my feet in the right position to throw it, you know? I could much rather just like get that thing going right here and kind of throw the fadeaway, you know? Yeah, for sure. Definitely. Yeah. Boy.
We just conversated about what we like, don't like, you know, up the middle. And he had a comment where he was saying he was just going to, on that certain play, he was just trying to get it to me quick. Hearing that's part of him, just things that he's thinking mid-play, you know, things like that. But that's why I'm here, is to learn him and his game and, you know, things he likes and doesn't like.
Hey, on that backhand one, like for me,
yeah,
when I'm ranging over there super hard, like, I'm just worried about getting rid of it quick.
Yeah, that's
so
fine.
I'm
that's
like,
fine. My job is to make it look like it was,
yeah,
perfect.
I'm not trying to like
put
it a certain place. Yeah, exactly. So just anticipate that a little bit. Everything's like nice. I would say just like as you feel that, like you're here, and then you kind of get like a little up, you know? So what I found, like that's a big key for me, just like playing anywhere on the infield, is like staying low like the whole way. It's like boom, like staying down there, so you can get that thing uphill.
Okay.
And I can get it and get on top of it, you know?
Sounds good.
Hey! Go ahead, son, get there! You ever been around PE, taking ground balls?
Huh?
Pedroia?
No, I haven't. I've talked with him a couple of times.
Yeah.
I haven't worked with him.
Talked with him when, like that first year I played second.
Uh-huh.
I was like, "What do you got for me, bro?" He's like, his whole thing was like, he wanted to like draw like a mini circle around second and like work within that little radius, you know?
Yeah, yeah.
He's like keeping like the hands like close in here, you know? Not feeling like he's like here to then like bring it back and then to transfer, you know? More about like moving his body to move his glove, yeah. Just like, bam, bam.
Just watching his attention to detail and how meticulous he is
with every single rep. I think it's honestly inspiring. It's motivational.
Probably playing knockout was a highlight.
Yeah, I didn't know we were gonna have basketball and football and all this, so it was interesting. So he trying to sneak that up on us so he can get an upper hand. I heard he was working out, you know, had shooting practice and stuff a couple days ago.
I have the best jump shot on the team. They all were doubting my abilities to be able to play basketball, but as you can see, I have the cutoff and the shaved head and the beard, so I could be like an NBA 2K creative player.
Yeah, no, my layups were tough.
Well, I mean, York needs to work on his layups. Missed about 4 layups.
I had a pretty good showing for not picking up a ball in a while.
I learned that Story could shoot the ball a little bit.
I was a double champ one day.
I was third out, whatever, every time, so pretty consistent there.
The most fun thing was just honestly proving somebody wrong in something, because I don't get to do that very often.
Competition like that is what we thrive on, and I think it's cool to see these guys in that environment. And any ways that we can do that, bring that out in these guys, that's part of the gig.
Never been to a camp like this.
It was just a lot of fun. We got a lot of good work in.
We're always trying to find ways to get better, especially when we could do it together.
Go ahead. Yeah, that's it. Oh. See? Good shit, baby. I see a lot of promise. I see these guys are hungry. I think that's the biggest thing. It reminds me of myself when, I was in their position in AA, AAA, and you can kind of sniff the big leagues, and that these guys are close, and just being around them and seeing their love for the game and, their work habits, and you can't be 1 foot in, 1 foot out. It has to be all the way in, and I think these guys are definitely cut from that cloth, so that's what excites me, really.
Yeah, those are money right there.
And I think it's just going to continue to grow, and we'll fine-tune it as we do it year after year, and hopefully we got 10, 15 guys out here next time.